What's up, nerds? I'm Ben.
I'm Nick.
And we've seen a little film you may have heard of called Us. We want to talk about the ending, right, Nick? If you haven't seen it, what are you doing here? Go away, see Us, come back, and let's have a chat. All right, so let's actually just recap for a moment and talk about the Wilsons. So who is left alive of the tethered or shadow versions of the Wilsons at this point?
So for the Wilson family's tethers, we have the father's dead. The daughter has been like folded like an accordion in the trees. But the son and the mother are still stalking that family across America and inexplicably get ahead of them to the next scene, which is something we have to talk about later. But what's interesting is the Tyler family, who we were introduced to, the well-to-do upper-class family, is all of them, every single one of them, and their echoes too.
Yeah, and we're driving along. It's sort of like night has passed. It's the next morning, and we come across the flaming wreckage of a vehicle. Who's standing in front of the vehicle?
We see the small boy is still alive. He survived being burned. We know he wears a surgical burns mask, and he is actually beckoning for the family, the Wilson family, to come closer until the son realizes, knowing himself cannot be trusted. Hey, can't trust yourself. He realizes it's a trap, and we see him.
It's a trap!
Oh, yeah. We see him back away, arms spread.
Yeah, nice slow motion shot as he backs away. Obviously, the rest of the Wilson family is looking on in shock and horror, but they miss the fact that the tethered version of a main character, is it Adelaide?
Adelaide. So this is Red. She comes out.
Red snatches the boy, takes him off screen, and then we realize the last section of this film is going to be mother versus mother down in the depths of, what are we calling it, like the tunnels of hell?
Well, I would call it the tunnels of hell because it's interesting. We go down this long travelator with this sort of yellow, eerie sort of look. We realize it's a laboratory. Shades of the Tuskegee experiment, if you will. It's not coincidental that I think Jordan Peele has selected this place as the final showdown, because some of the best horror movies always originate from a lab, so we finish it in a lab. And eerily enough, in a schoolroom.
Yeah, rabbits everywhere. There's obviously a big rabbit thing going on here.
Yeah.
And we have our, there's no sign of the boy, but we have our face off in this classroom. You call it a classroom?
It is a classroom because we see her she's drawn on the board, these stick figures joined together in white, and she's cut out this eerie reference of Red, only holding two figures together as if it's time for them to untether from each other.
And they have a great face off, the two of them. They're dancing around each other because they're both obviously were ballet students when they were younger. There's some great cross-cutting going on from when they were kids to now. And our main character, our heroine, if you will, she's getting carved up. Like, Adelaide is straight up getting carved up by Red. And it's not looking good for her. The fight goes out in the hallway.
Red and Adelaide end up face-to-face with each other, and Adelaide has impaled Red brutally. But that's not all, is it?
No, not at all.
If you watch very carefully, when she's strangling the light from Red's face, we see something flash across Adelaide, a sort of visual hiccup, this weird sort of glee and teeth showing, fangs, just like the tethers did. And this was actually the third time during the movie they had indicated to us. And we begin to realize something is off. Even the son, when he comes out to hug his mother, seems hesitant.
But we don't actually get that answer for a while, do we?
No.
I mean, and you say that this is the third time we've seen it. You picked up on these little hints throughout that this main character of Adelaide could actually be Red, and it's flipped. And sure enough, when they head back above ground, they're getting in the car, they're driving away, and have a little bit of a flashback back to the very start of the film when the young girl who turns up to be Adelaide is actually Red. And holy shit, we realize it's been her the whole freaking time.
It's not coincidence we have a t-shirt for Thriller on a character that gets switched up in a horror night. It's always been referenced. It's a reference to one of the greatest music videos in which one bad night we know a demon comes out of it. And we realize they have switched around. It is Janice. It is the doppelganger. It is the nightmare. And all along, we haven't had a story about an uprising. We have had a story of an attempted retribution, and the actual hero was killed.
Oh, poetic. And the son is obviously in that last scene. They're in the car, they're driving away. He's looking at her like, does he know that his mother isn't really who she says she is? Well, I think the whole idea is that it's the spinning top from Inception, right? You're supposed to believe what you want to believe. There's no hard and fast rule. There's a hint, but it's not quite confirmed.
He pulls his mask down. Is that pulling the wool over his eyes? Because we know Jordan Peele and Wool's done that before.
It's quite possible. I think Jordan Peele's the kind of guy that likes to just... There's no hard and fast, like, answer, right? He puts little clues in there and says, look, make up your own mind. There's no... I like films that don't tie everything up in a neat little bow, and I don't think this film did that at all.
We exit with a final shot of this line, the hands across America, helicopters sitting, waiting, as if observing, trying to figure out what's going to happen. And so, for us, what was going to happen? What was meant to be the end result of this macabre experiment of human unification?
It's just, there's so many things to unpack in this film. We've just talked about the last 10 minutes. If you want to hear about the rest of the film in spoiler detail, check out our spoiler review. Until next time, guys, we'll see you nerds at the movies.
Did you notice that facial tic I mentioned? Did you notice some of the intimate imageries of Thriller and all the other stuff layered in? Let us know below.
Did you notice the pulling the wool over one's eyes?